It's not the prettiest facility, obviously.
Oh, well, girl, do you trust me? Trust me.
We do intake, breezeway, adoption. Mm-hmm. Intake's for our new arrivals and dogs we don't have room to move over, and then adoption's the dogs that are ready for adoption.
I'm Jamie. I'm the director of the Cleveland Ballerfa County Animal Shelter.
The hounds are the first group here.
This is definitely one of the bigger intakes we've done, especially large breed dogs that we've done. We absolutely would consider this to be an animal cruelty case, and I know in larger cities, I'm sure charges would be pressed. In this situation, you know, we are not well averse in going to court, so our situation, we want to just retain custody of the dogs.
Oh, there's the big boy.
Towser and Stella.
Hi, Towser and Stella. Hi.
Then Rufus. And then Zuma and Raven.
Oh, okay.
This is another dirt road rescue. They're warriors because they're dealing with unspeakable circumstances. No money, no help, that are doing the best they can with what they have to work with. So I really feel compelled to want to really help them.
Clifford's covered because he had, you know, I'm telling you, he had a little cough. And then these are my girls, this Trusty and Ladybird. These two break my heart because my vet thinks they're at least a year old.
Oh my gosh.
Ladybird had, her feet were so swollen when she got here, so she had a secondary skin infection on top of Demodex.
They're so tiny. Stunted. Yeah.
When they were, we had them separated at first, but they were so terrified we put them together.
I do not think that the unsocialized, the scared, no other rescue is going to step up for them because it is difficult, especially when they're heartworm positive and when they're terrified of people. Most rescues are going to go, you know, that's too much for me. So I think that that was the only chance for them to get out as a group and to get out. Everybody was with Tia to step up and do this.
Adding 8 more dogs to our rescue, period, is a lot. Then you throw in the fact that they're hounds, which are a little bit more challenging. Then you throw in the fact that these dogs have some serious medical issues and behavioral issues. You know, it's a triple threat.
Stella.
Oh, when they get going, the whole kennel gets to going.
What are you barking at, Stella? Stella, what's the matter, girl? What's the matter?
I love that sound.
I did, yeah.
The whole kennel gets to going. They taught one of our little pit mix puppies how to howl just from hearing them do it.
You can't judge any dog in a shelter environment. I always equate that to somebody who's in prison. The person that's in prison is not the person that's out here, and vice versa. When we get a dog out of a shelter or we see a dog in a shelter, we never make, you know, knee-jerk assessments.
The only one that's been a little twitchy was Ladybird, but even she's doing so much better.
Yeah.
Stella rode in my passenger seat. I took her to the vet riding in my passenger seat.
Yeah.
And Towser will go with anybody. He's never met a stranger. He doesn't hold a grudge.
I'm Towser.
He does not hold a grudge for the conditions he's lived in.
Look at his picture.
Yeah, his poor little eyes were just awful.
It was just like nose.
The one thing I did notice out of all of these dogs is the one that was the most outgoing was the big male that they had named Towser. The shelter people, they said, oh yeah, he's like completely untraumatized, at least emotionally. Now he was the worst physically, which is pretty amazing. He's the worst shape, but yet he's the one with the boldest temperament and personality.
You look like my Neely. You look like my Neely.
You know, there's no way to figure out why, just like humans. Some people handle traumatic situations better than others. So Towser is probably just one of those dogs.
Which time y'all open tomorrow?
Somebody will be here by 7. I typically get here at 8. We can get here as early as y'all need.
Yeah, we can get here at 8.
I know that was a long drive. We appreciate y'all making
it. It's okay. I got wild animals to deal with in my van too. So So we'll come in the morning.
I tell people all the time, because we get asked every day if we're full. We're always full. We take in about 1,000 animals a year. Our rate versus our population is about 5.2%, so we're about 2 times the national average for intakes for our population. You're not treading water in the South with animal rescue. You're drowning. You're just drowning slow.
That's great. That's a great way. That's a sad, great way of putting it.
Yeah. Tomorrow morning, we're going to come back, load them up, and then head back to Louisiana so that we can get back home at a decent hour and get the dogs unloaded.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We're really excited for them.
They're pretty cute.
Okay.
Good morning.
We're going to start with, like, the lab and the 2 smaller hounds. Okay. No, they're not leash trained, but we can loop them, and then we'll carry them out. But at least if they have a leash and they start biting, we have to drop them. We got them on a leash, you know, kind of thing.
Because these dogs had come from a horrific situation when they were rescued off the property, to then be put in a shelter, which no matter what shelter, it is a scary situation.
Hi, Roof.
All right, he's big. He's heavier.
Okay.
Okay, baby. It's okay.
Of course,
it's
that okay. Construction next door is not helping.
You're okay, baby. Okay, I got him.
Right.
Honestly, a dog that is afraid, the more closed in they are, the safer they feel. So the van was going to become a safe place very quickly.
All right, let's put Bowser in first, because he's going in the back.
He's excited.
And then I got to scoot her and pass my wild animals. Come on, bud, come be with your people. Good boy. There you go. I know, it's one of your peeps. Come on, come on. Come on, Mama. Come on, Stella. There you go. Come on.
Come on, baby girl.
Come on. I know, it's different. Come on.
There
Don't worry
go.
About them. Don't worry about them.
All right, come on, babies.
Come on, baby.
Look right
in.
Out of all the dogs, what's upsetting me the most is the black lab.
Hi, Mama.
So terrified.
Hi, Raven.
Oh, oh, she's peeing.
And when they're peeing and pooping on you and trying to bite you, it's fear. You know, and I don't mean to stereotype, but, you know, labs, they're like so outgoing. They're just so outgoing. And to see that dog just terrified, you just think, wow, you know, wow. So many questions that we're never gonna be able to get the answers for.
Oh, look at them. Hi, little miniatures. I can't tell you how excited we are for them and for y'all to make this big trip for these dogs.
Hopefully they come out of it, you know, okay, as far as their emotional state.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much.
Right, guys,
everybody. Thank you so much.
The first thing is to get medical done and go from there.
Stop. Stop. Jethro. Stop. Stop. Did you bring all the medical?
Yep.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. Okay.
Yeah, some of them are on meds already.
We had everything worked out for these dogs. We did not put them in like main population within our kennel system. We actually had a mobile home that was set up for them.
These two definitely are buddies.
Okay.
These two are buddies. Then that's the purebred lab.
They almost look like they could. They
well,
look the same.
That's
body
what we were
shape.
All talking about. Because look at this guy. It's like a black bloodhound almost.
I know. They like
it,
could
looks,
all.
Yeah.
Well, they were all at the same breeder, right? They were all the same.
Yeah.
Place.
And then I have the two purebred puppies. Oh, but look how sad the lab looks, though.
I know.
He's the one that looks the saddest.
He does.
That's the one coughing, too, so I wonder if he doesn't feel good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He looks so, he's like so sad.
Like, he's definitely gonna be
he was
one.
The worst
I'm
one
get
coming out.
Yeah, and everybody else
one.
Is like, oh, this is good.
He was the one that was, I think,
panicked.
Peeing in my arms when I was handing him off to you.
Well, I'll make him the first one I take it, because that is definitely heartworm.
Yeah, so I am sure they all have heartworm.
And
Towser,
it's like a
do you have fleas, buddy?
Yeah, Towser's been eating himself all the
Yeah,
time.
He must have fleas, because now I'm scratching.
Every dog that we get in is filled with parasites, especially when they come from like rural environments. And where those dogs came from was a really nasty, dirty environment. But now it's just a matter of just getting the dogs healthy, you know, and start their heartworm treatment when they're ready.
Is that the one, the big, that's the big
Oh,
name?
Yeah, that's
Towser.
It's Towser. That's trouble looking for a place to happen.
I know.
He's got a lot to say.
A lot to say. What, Towser?
They don't look as skinny.
They look better today.
They look happier.
He's comfy.
Yeah.
I wonder if he's older than 5. He looks old in the face.
He's gonna be big when he gets
healthy. Yeah, he's like a baby Mosifus.
I think they look like less shut
they look
down
young.
Today.
Yeah.
You know?
It's also really quiet over here.
They have their own house.
They're
watching
place.
Movies.
They're decompressing. Like I was like, when I walked in, I'm like, oh my gosh, this could not be more perfect for this group of dogs.
At this point, it's just getting them healthy enough to get to know them better so that eventually they can get adopted.
Look at her, she's gonna sleep.
Yeah.